May I come to the gentleman at the back here?
Yeah, I have a question, please.
Yes, of course.
I'm talking about honesty when you try to get a new client. What we our compliance is, instead of 5%, is now almost 45%. So okay. It's a big thing.
Okay.
Now, you make a new quotation for a new client, and we now lost already twice a business of 50,000 to up to 100,000.
Okay.
Not by telling the client there is so much compliance. So there are big firms not telling it, get the client in. Of course, the client is angry afterwards, but they will not change for the next 2 years.
Yes.
So they get the 50,000-100,000 business in. Now, we all will probably say, okay, we're not that kind of firm. We are professional. We have integrity. But in the end, we lose the business. So the honesty can also go against you. And that's a problem we are facing at the moment.
It is. So if that was formulated as a question that I can actually tackle for you, what question would that be? How to handle that particular issue?
Yeah, you want to stay integrity, you want to be honest, you want to build up your professional organization for
yes.
the long term, but in the end, you don't get a business in that particular field. How would you?
How do we handle this? Right. So the full answer to the question is what I spend my life doing sort of all year round, so it's a bit of a long explanation. So for the sake of the entire audience, may I just condense it slightly to one's particular tip. Generally, we do not stay in control of the process from start to finish. Generally, we will have a first meeting. They will say, great, let's talk again sometime. That meeting never takes place. Or we will ask for the books and records, and they never show up, or whatever it may be. And things drift. And then we call, and we email, and we don't know if we're being too pushy or not pushy enough, or what we're doing. And we lose control, and conversations drift. And therefore, competing ideas come, and other priorities take over. The more we are in control of a current client or a current prospect and have the next meeting, not the next action, but the next meeting in the diary at all times, the less chance we've got of that problem arising. If we would like, if we could to have some time after this presentation, we can talk about that in far more detail. I'd love to talk to you more about that if I may. But for now, I have to leave it there because I've got all the slides I've got to do and there's people here. You know. So let's move on. Okay. This is something. This is a little story I'm going to tell you before we build our pipeline to try and give you some time to think about who your TOMs might actually be. I'm hoping that as you wrote down those seven avenues, you started to think of who your TOMs might actually be. Names were coming to mind that you could perhaps contact. So I'm going to tell you about Tom. Tom is the everyman that we've talked about so far, today's owner managers. And I'm going to explain a typical situation that I find in every firm I go to and see if it connects with you. This is Tom. We've already explained who he is. You don't need to meet him again. We already know that he's a growth business, an ambitious growth business, a profitable, ambitious growth business. We know that he's someone trying to get somewhere. So that's the kind of person we'd love to work with because that's someone who's open to conversations beyond compliance with us. So okay, that's fine, but let's meet Thomas Manufacturing, his business. Thomas Manufacturing is also a pretty switched-on organization. They're an organization who love Tom. They've been with him since very early on. He's a charismatic leader. They want to do well for him. So they are engaged, they are motivated, they are invested, and this business is great. It's going places. But because it's going places, it has all kinds of issues behind it that are causing problems for Tom. Let's meet the accounting firm. Now, Tom has an accounting firm. As usual, it's one that he's been with for many, many years. The relationship is very cozy. He gets on fine with his accountants. There are no issues. Tom can't be unhappy with what his current accountant does because his current accountant is not incompetent. And as a result, the work that they do is perfectly okay, and the relationship is perfectly okay. And Tom doesn't know how it could be any better than okay, so it stays at okay the entire time. Because the practice don't educate Tom, and Tom does not educate himself. So as a result, we have an okay relationship all the time. That's okay. The accountant then decides to try and educate Tom because they've got to grip with marketing. We're going to market ourselves now. We're going to start you know, reaching out to our current clients and our new potential clients at the same time. So we're going to reach out to Tom now, and they try to do it by email marketing, which is a technique that many of us use. Now, when we email market, of course, for many of us Toms, that is, it ends up in our junk or our spam, or if it finds the way into the inbox, it has a title that tells us it's not urgent. Your invitation to, join us for, we would like you to, and so on. We know that's not a now email, so it goes away, and it gets filed. And the intention that Tom had was to look at this. He meant to look at it, he just never did. Thomas Manufacturing, very busy business, plenty going on. So as a result, the accountant's first attempt to educate Tom on what else can be done beyond compliance work has failed because it didn't get past the first post. It went into junk or spam, or Tom never got around to reading it. So therefore, Tom's understanding of what his accounting firm does is whatever he currently buys from the firm. So if I ask Tom and I say, Tom, what does your firm do for you? He'll say, well, audit, tax, accounts, and they do other things. I know, I saw an email from them once. They do other things, but I couldn't tell you what they were. So that is the first stage. That's where we're all at. That's where us Toms are all at. We're at this first stage of, you do other things, but I don't know what they are. So therefore, you have to educate us. And some firms are successful in educating. They do manage it, and therefore, Tom's perception moves on one. And we go through to a different level of, we understand that you do more things, we just don't know what those things are.